let us discuss on another problem, that is a time ember. Okay, so earlier it was only the connection between the plates, okay, in fillet weld, that is lap joint as well as butt joint, whereas here we will be discussing on another problem, that is how to design a welded connection when we connect a truss member or a tie member in a to a gusset plate. Okay, here we have an example. Okay, so simply it is a gusset plate. Okay, and two angles are connected on either side of the gusset plate. The size of angle is already given. What he has said? Okay, he has given a size of member, that is 100 by 75 by 8. Okay, here we have an example of connection. Okay, so here it is a gusset plate. This is example. Okay, here the members used are different. Okay, so in a truss, a truss member is connected to a gusset plate using welding on either side. Okay, L1 and L2 are the length of welds. Okay, and here they applied some load, and this is CXX value. Okay, later we'll discuss. Okay, simply this is the case in our problem. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll start with the problem. Okay, first I'll read out the problem. A tie member of a roof truss consists of two ISA 100 by 75 by 8 mm. Okay, so here we'll switch to steel table. So here we have ISA 100 by 75 by 8 mm. Okay, the properties are here. Okay, its thickness is 8 mm, cross section area 13.36 cm square, that is 1336 mm square. Okay, its a unit weight. Okay, it is 10.5 kg per meter. Okay, when you take an angle, okay, its a weight will be around 10.5 kg or 103 Newton per meter. Okay, and its a center of gravity. From the top, it is 31.0. Okay, in x direction CXX, in y direction it is 18.7. X direction means on higher side, that is 100. Okay, in 100 direction its CG is from CG is existed at 3.10 centimeter, that is 31 mm from the corner. Okay, whereas in y direction it is 18.7 mm. Okay, we'll discuss. Okay, here he has given two ISA 100 by 75 by 8 mm. The angles are connected to either side of 10 mm thick gusset plate. The thickness of the gusset plate here it is 10 mm. Okay, whereas the thickness of angle is how much? 8 mm. Okay, so thickness of thinner plate will be 8 mm. Keep it in mind. The angles are connected to either side of 10 mm thick gusset plates, and the member is subjected to a working pull of 300 kilonewton. Okay, both angles on either side of the gusset plate will carry total working pull of, working load of how much? Pull means it may be a tension. Okay, obviously it will be a tension. Okay, 300 kilonewton. Okay, no need to design the welded connection. Assume connections are made in workshop. Okay, when it is in workshop, the factor of safety is 1.25. That is gamma MW is 1.25. Okay, here the working load is 300 mm. So we are writing a given data, working load 300 mm. So we should design. Okay, when we design, obviously we should take a design load or a factored load. Okay, for a load factor of safety is 1.5. So it is 300 into 1.5. Okay, how much it will be? 300 into 1.5, 450 kilonewton. Okay, together these two angles will carry 450 kilonewton. Okay, and each angle carry 450 divided by 2. 450 divided by 2 means how much? 225 kilonewton. Okay, so here, as we have discussed in previous classes, here the angle, okay, here we have two connections. One is at square edge, another one is at rounded edge. Okay, we'll see here one welding may be done at this rounded edge and another will be at this square edge. Okay, so we should find out two TEs. Okay, effective throat thicknesses. Here we have का थिकनेस ऑफ वेल्ड व्हेन बिफोर फाइंडिंग द लेंथ ऑफ वेल्ड रिक्वायर्ड फॉर दिस कनेक्शन. दिस इज अ डिज़ाइन प्रॉब्लम. ओके, वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द लेंथ ऑफ वेल्ड. द लोड इज गिवन. द सेम इक्वेशन विच वी हैव यूज इन लास्ट प्रॉब्लम, इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव यूज्ड. विल बी यूजिंग सेम इक्वेशन, ओनली द डिफरेंस इज वॉट, लोड इज गिवन टू यू, यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट लेंथ ऑफ वेल्ड. ओके, सो हियर इट इज ए टाइम मेंबर. ओके, वी नो एवरीथिंग. ओके, सो एट द राउंडेड टो ऑफ द एंगल सेक्शन द साइज ऑफ वेल्ड शुड नॉट एक्सीड 3/4 ऑफ द थिकनेस. 3/4 ऑफ द थिकनेस. ओके, सो विल स्विच टू IS 800. यू हैव दिस गाइडलाइन हियर, सो हियर इट इज. ओके, फॉर राउंडेड एज द थिकनेस ऑफ द थ्रोट थिकनेस ऑफ द वेल्ड शुड बी. ओके, इट इज एट अ गैप ऑफ 1/4 फ्रॉम द टॉप. ऑब्वियसली इफ इट इज 1/4 द रिमेनिंग विल बी 3/4 ऑफ द टोटल थिकनेस. ओके, अमंग दिस टी वैल्यू के वन वी शुड नॉट कंसिडर दिस 1/4 ऑफ टी. सो द रिमेनिंग विल बी 3/4 ऑफ टी हियर. ओके, सो 3/4 ऑफ टी मीन्स यू आर टेकन 3/4 ऑफ थिकनेस. थिकनेस ऑफ एंगल इज हाउ मच? थिकनेस ऑफ एंगल गिवन हियर, ओके, 8 mm. ओके, सो यू शुड कंसिडर 3/4 ऑफ थिकनेस. थिकनेस ऑफ थिनर प्लेट, ऑब्वियसली वी हैव वन एंगल थिकनेस, अनदर वन इज गसेट प्लेट थिकनेस. ओके, अमंग दीज टू द थिनर वन इज 8 mm. सो आई विल बी टेकिंग 3/4 ऑफ 8. ओके, सो 3/4 ऑफ 8 विल बी हाउ मच? इट इज 6 mm. ओके, सो वन साइड एट राउंडेड एज, हियर हियर वी हैव राउंडेड एज. ओके, सो हियर थिकनेस ऑफ वेल्ड और इफेक्टिव थ्रोट द साइज ऑफ वेल्ड विल बी हाउ मच? ओके, साइज ऑफ वेल्ड विल बी 6 mm. ओके, एट अनदर साइड, दिस इज एट वन एंड. ओके, राउंडेड एज. ओके, एट टॉप द थिकनेस शुड नॉट एक्सीड. ओके, हियर another one is here, it is a square edge. Okay, as we seen in a what steel table, here we have square edge, exactly square. Okay, so for square edges, how much it will be? 1.5 mm less than the total thickness of thinner plate. 1.5 mm less than the total thickness of thinner plate. Here it is, thinner plate is how much? Okay, among these two, again among angle section as well as gusset plate, thinner one is 8 mm. So that's why we are taking T is equal to 8 minus 1.5. 1.5 need to be deducted here, okay, as per the caudal provisions, right? It is written in page number 80. Okay, page number 80, figure number 17A. So it will be T minus 1.5. 8 minus 1.5, it is 6.5. Okay, instead of 6.5, it is difficult to measure. Okay, so hence we'll provide 6 mm on either side. Okay, here also I'll be taking 6 mm, and here also I'll be taking 6 mm on either side. Okay, both sides, the first this one as well as this one, I'll be taking S is equal to 6 mm. So no, okay, so I'll solve using only one thickness of weld. Okay, so each angle, there are two angles, total load is 450 kilonewton. So two angles are there. Okay, here you can see the two angles, one angle and second angle. Okay, so each angle carry a factored pull off. Total load is 450, so each angle carry a load of 225 kilonewton. 450 divided by 2, it will be equal to 225 kilonewton. So now we need to find out the length of weld. Okay, it is a fillet weld, you know, it is a fillet weld. Okay, when we are connecting, okay, one member over another one, it is a fillet weld. Okay, let we need to find out the value of LW here. Before that, we should know effective throat thickness. Here we have calculated size of weld. Okay, only we got value of S. Okay, all the thing we required is the equation written is LW into TE. Okay, so TE is equal to, in a fillet weld, TE is equal to 0.707 into S. Okay, 0.707 into 6 mm, it is 4.24 mm. Okay, so I'll substitute these values. You know where Fu. Okay, Fu here he has not given. Obviously, it will be 410 mm, 410 newton per mm square, and load strength of weld, or the load on the connection, both are same. Okay, so I'll be taking 225 into 10 to the power of 3. It is in kilonewton, so I'll keep it in newton. okay, because all the values are Newton and mm. Okay, 410 LW, which I need to find out. Next one, effective throat thickness. Okay, T we have calculated 4.24 mm, and next one, root 3 gamma MW. Okay, we have discussed about this equation in last problems also. So the value of LW is equal to how much? When you calculate, LW will be equal to 280 mm. Okay, so earlier in last problem, okay, in last problem, we'll switch to the last problem. Okay, so on either direction we have a CG of this plate is exactly at the center, so we have taken same length of weld on either side, whereas here it is quite difficult. There should not be any eccentric effects. Okay, so I must weld accordingly. Okay, so before fixing, total length is how much? Total length here we got 280. I'm not supposed to take 140 on either side, because the CG is somewhere else. CG is not exactly at the center. Okay, that I need to find out. Okay, so which angle you are using? Okay, in a problem he has given 100/75/8. Okay, from top here here I am using 100 mm, so it is written here. Okay, and here, okay, the connecting leg is of, this is connecting leg and this is outstanding leg. Connecting leg is of 100 mm and outstanding leg is of 75 mm. Okay, so from here to here, okay, you need to find out CXX. Okay, it is there in steel table. So we are using 100/75/8. So value of CXX is how much? CG from the top. Okay, CG in the X direction, here we have CXX value. Okay, in steel table we have CXX value. Okay, this is longer leg, that is of 100 mm, and this is shorter leg, that is 75 mm. Okay, here in our problem, this is connecting leg and this is outstanding leg. So value of CXX is here. How much it is? 100/75/8. CXX value is 3.10 cm. When it comes to the value in mm, it is 31 mm. So we'll switch to the problem. Okay, CXX value is how much? You have taken 31 mm. From the top, it should be 31. Okay, among 100 mm, if it is 31, remaining will be how much? 69. Now we need to find out the exact length value of L1 and L2. Okay, we'll equate, when it comes to CG, we'll equate these two values using the CXX and the remaining value. Okay, CG values, right? Okay, so what I'll do, I'll take L1 into 31, L1 is length of weld into length of weld into the value of CXX, and L2 into remaining length. Okay, so it is 100, 100 minus 31, it will be 69. So L1 into 31 and L2 into 69. Here we have written L1 into 31 is equal to, we are equating, okay, is equal to L2 into 69. So what I'll do, I'll write a equation. L1 is equal to, we got how much? 69/31. So L1 will be equal to 2.22 times L2. Okay, L1 will be equal to 2.22 times L2. Now we know the thing is that L1 plus L2 is equal to LW. Here we have LW. Okay, we need to fix this LW somewhere here. Okay, with a specific L1 and L2 values. Together L1 and L2, that will be LW, that is 280 mm. So I written equation L1 plus L2 is equal to LW. Okay, so you know L1 is equal to how much? 2.22 times L2. So I'll use this equation and substitute here. So L1 plus L2 is equal to LW. That means instead of L1, I'll be writing, we have solved this one. Okay, so we have solved one equation, that is L1 is equal to 2.22 L2. I'll submit here. Okay, I'll substitute here 2.22 into L2 plus L2. Okay, this one. Okay, this L2 will be here. Okay, total it is 3.22 L2 is equal to LW. We know the value of LW. How much it is? 280 mm. Okay, so 280/3.22. So L2 value will be how much? 280/ whatever the things are there. Okay, this 2.22 L2 plus 1 L2, it will be 3.22 L2. 280/3.22, how much you got? 87 mm. So this value, L2 value, is how much? 87 mm. Now we need to find out value of L1. Okay, So if it is 80 to 87 mm, okay, remaining will be how much? 2.22. We know this L2 value. Substitute this value in this equation. So L1 is equal to how much? 2.22 into L2. Okay, 2.22 L2, how much it is? 193. Together it must be equal to how much? 280 mm. Okay, or you can easily find out 87 LW is here also. Okay, you can bring this value and substitute in this equation also. 280 minus value of L2. So 280 minus 87, obviously it is equal to 193 itself. Okay, so in this way we will be calculating the length of weld for the single or double angles. Okay, so here we got length of weld for a single angle because we have divided the load. Okay, now the same welding will be the same force, same member is on either other side of a gusset plate, and the same force is applied. Obviously the welding will also be done at same length. Okay, here also on either side L1 will be equal to 193 and L2 is equal to 87 mm. Okay, if it is single angle, obviously total load, no need to divide here. If it is single angle, no need to divide this load. Okay, simply need to solve the procedure. Whatever the load is given, okay, we'll take directly. Okay, we'll take directly here. Suppose if it is 100 mm factored load, okay, I'll be taking 100 here, or that is if it is factored, I must take. If it is working, you need to multiply, no need to divide. If it is single angle, so this division is done only because we are using two angles. Both angles together carry a factored load of 450. Okay, we are only calculating for one angle on either. Okay, length of weld for one angle, and remaining is also same. That's why I'll apply. Okay, I'll apply same length of weld on other side. Okay, 450 divided by 2 is equal to 225. Okay, so that's why I divided, calculated for one angle and applied for the both. Okay, thank you.